Plot, Warriors of the Empire, and welcome back to another episode of Starfleet Command, Orion Pirates Plus Mod. I am Rear Admiral Tirak of the heavy battlecruiser IKV Vengeance, and we rejoin our heavy battlecruiser behind enemy lines and in desperate need of repair and rearm. We just barely managed to escape from another light cruiser patrol last mission, so let's get back into things and let's get out of here. We're leaving. No. Cannot afford to go on missions. Because we need supplies. We're also going to check the shipyard. Actually, how much is our ship worth right now? It's worth 1,100-ish. So we'll keep that in mind. FD7 Plus, that's a battle cruiser type. Two Disruptor 4s. We're not interested in that sort of thing. We want something big and nasty like us. Maybe even bigger and nastier than us. Although finding a 4,000 cost X-series ship could be a little bit difficult. DXD, this is going to be an advanced technology drone bombardment cruiser, battle cruiser. Wow, that's a mouthful. Advanced technology drone bombardment battle cruiser. 6 Disruptor 4s, 6 missile rack Bs, 7 phaser Xs, and 6 AMDs. Wow. Now that is quite a bit of firepower right there. Now I don't know if these... I would assume that these 3 phaser Xs all fire forward. It's only got 42 power, but it requires 3 less than the other ship, but it included 4 more from... So he's going to be a little bit slower. A little bit slower. But still, that would be pretty monstrously strong. How much was that? You know, if we can, like, overcome the fact that it's only 3,000, because most of its armament is disposable. Gotcha. We could go for a CX Light Dreadnought, 5 Disruptor 4s, 5 Missile Racks, 4 Phaser 3s, 10 Phaser Xs. We can actually probably afford that, I think, if we sell the Vengeance... But I think it would be better if we naturally saved up for it. So just a little quick check of the shipyard right now tells me wait a little while because the best may be yet to come. So patch, 4 brand new admin shuttles, a total restock on missiles, that's more expensive, and get our marines back up to full because we use a lot of them. They're too useful not to use, quite frankly. This is going to be a really expensive dry dock bill. Like, what did you do to the ship? We got involved in a war, man. Chill. Missions. Surprise reversed. Oh god, yes. Please, yes. A surprise reversed for a planetary assault. This is great. Hit that red alert, and let's go to full power. It looks like we're jumping on House of Korgath? Nope, Beast Raiders. Beast Raiders. The cool thing about the Beast Raiders is that they can actually have beasts in their fleet. Which, admitted, that's actually pretty cool. We will prep the scatter pack just in case. We do have quite a bit of things to crunch down on. A light cruiser, a frigate. We've been detected, by the way. Another frigate, and another frigate. So, kill him, then him, then him, then him. You get the idea. It's going to be the very traditional surprised reversed. Maximum power for maximum speed, please. We want to get in there before they can get away, silhouetted against this gigantic nebula in the background. Very gorgeous, very beautiful. And, yeah. We're only supported by a G2 in this operation, so not great. I love that a tiny police gunboat manages to warrant the name Devastator. Sure, buddy. But hey, Vengeance is always here to back you up. Ooh, do we have a... No, it's a battle frigate. I think... Or no, Beast Raider, leader, plus one. So, first variant, leader type, plus variant. Yeah, Orion Pirates. Beast Raider, cruiser type, plus variant, type D. Which is apparently equipped with photon torpedoes. Scatter packs set and ready to rock. So, we're gonna soar on in here. And we're going to unload everything except the missiles, because 2 of our missiles are going to miss. Okay. All up in select. We're going to pass through. Perfect. Okay. So we were able to kill 1 on a total overhaul. The Wind Chaser. Cute. I think that he's got that one sorted. We're now going to... Yeah, we're going to turn, because we need to reduce speed. Where is my mind today? Not thinking about what's going on, that's where. He's not able to damage Windchaser's fantastic point defense system. We will dump a shuttlecraft. and move on to the next. Because that's how we roll. Gotta cause as much damage as we can across multiple vectors. There goes the scatter pack. We will watch and watch. And the timing on this is actually going to be really tight. 4, 3, sorry. Wow, he shot on a lot of them. Two of them still hit, though. And onto the leader. Because he is the next target indeed. Forward weapons are charged, ready to rock. Well, except for the phasers. Alright, so disruptors are charged and ready to rock. We'll close in nice and tight to cause as much damage as we can. Closer. Closer. That's the range. We did 20 damage, so not bad. 5 damage per disruptor. I guess that's our maximum. And then another 21 damage from phasers. Proving that phasers are possibly the greatest weapon in this game. Are you still having trouble with this guy? The Prigger. I'm not even going to comment. He simply cannot fire in a way that his missiles will get through. So let's support him a little bit. Going to close in and end his life. He is using B-type racks, which are of the extended magazines. Extended magazines, of course, being incredibly useful for staying power, especially on long war patrols. Talk to your dealer about extended magazines today. Full fire! 43 damage. Our burst crunch is just not super high. It's not. I mean, it's okay. But we're a battlecruiser. There we go. Last one. Hello, BWRR2. That's a bit of a name. He's equipped with 3 Phaser 1s and 2 missile launchers. It will not save you, sir. Now is the end of your life. Missiles and everything. Let's see how much that manages to take away from the sector control. Because I would like to take control of the sector without too much more hassle. It's been hassle. Nothing but trying to take this one. 300 prestige, and it's a neutral. Pop. Pop. We'll go on a patrol. Data recovery would actually be simpler, because data recovery, if we ran into the worst, we could fly around the enemy ships and rush off to the snaps fingers, tries to recall the name of it, the listening post. So increase our speed up to our combat speed of 18. There's nothing on long-range sensors. The Devastator is here once again with us, supporting us in its endeavors. And we will put on another missile boat. Get ready to dump that at anybody who looks at us funny. That's important. People shouldn't look at you funny. Because if they do, well then that's the point where you smash them over the head. And because you're Klingon, those ridges, and it gets messy. But that's what the Klingon way. It's a heavy cruiser, so this is going to be a fight. And we will probe fire. It's an interesting angle. How did I get that? Oh, F2. F1. F2. F3, F4, and F5 disables the camera lock. So what has he got? Show me everything. He's a carrier with decent shielding. Okay. We can take that. I believe we can take that. So we will... are we still prepping a scatter pack? Did I remember to do that this time? Yes, we did. The scatter pack is getting ready, being loaded up as we speak with the 6 missiles, Klingon crews hauling them from the magazines, which are somewhere around here, into the shuttle bay, which is somewhere around here, and loading them one by one into this big, like, pallet thing that goes in the back of the admin shuttle. And then the shuttle is dumped out, waits a couple of seconds, the pallet top blows off, and then missiles go flying everywhere. The engines turning on destroy the shuttle, and that's how that works. That's my mental image of how all of that works. Missiles go! How many fighters are we dealing with here? I see one group. Only one group. Okay, that totally works for me. I'm not complaining. Do not interpret my statement as that's a complaint. It's not. Are you gonna suddenly stop, or are you gonna turn off? You're gonna turn off. You're going to reveal the fighters. You know what that reminds me of? And this may sound a little bit weird. The A-wing slash from Star Wars, because the A-wing slash is the A-wings come in. Were we not targeting something, or did we blow up a different group? I'm confused. Anyway, so the A-Wings hide in the signature of another ship as it flies in front of them, and then they suddenly pop out like daisies and lunge for the weak Imperial convoy. It's a very cool strategy, and it makes a lot of sense. And the idea is that he's hiding his fighters in his warp behind his ship, and then pops them out. Like, turns hard, lets the fighters go ripping forward at maximum speed. Crap. I misjudged. But I'm about to pop four missiles in the face. Oh, and you took them like a champ. So my idea there was I was going to do the Maverick maneuver. Pop the brakes, he'll fly right by. I misinterpreted his energy state, and he, well, he did that. Which is not good. We do need to turn. We do need to get off of this position. It's actually not super dangerous. He only has phasers. I mean, if he had, like, Hellbores or something, I would be screwed. Marines? Take him. If you kill him, I'm gonna be pissed. Just putting that out there right now. He's turning. He wanted to bring his other G-type phasers online. They did not work. So we're gonna soar away from you now, sir. We have you captured. Devastator, don't you dare. Don't you dare! Speed up. Maximum time. Get some distance in here. Because I want to capture the Exile. Also, Devastator, just fly away. Stay away. Let my crews do the work. That's the point of this entire exercise. Stolen! Yes, that's how we do. That is indeed how we do. So yet another ship, stolen for the glorious Klingon Empire. I should keep a tally for this. We've stolen so many ships. And it's ours. It's all ours. We'll go on this mission. It's a scouting mission to support, and then we will pull into our own personal dry dock after having taken the planet. It's the Eye of the Tiger right there, yo. It's another heavy cruiser. Another one of these big, nasty Hydran heavy cruisers. Shields are up. Speed is at cruise. Reinforce the forward shields. Not the forward side, just the forwards. That'll be fine. And reinforce right there. Prepping a scatter pack. We have entered enemy. Scan as many units as possible. Blah, 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 blah. Excellent. Probe is not yet ready. It takes one turn to charge. And probe. Oh, that's cool too. We are in a very interesting place spatially. We're between that and that. That's pretty cool. So, incoming probe. He does have shields. Shock. So, what is behind the shields? He's a DG plus DG. I would normally ascribe that to, like, Destroyer, but no, he is armed with four Hellbores as a full-on big cruiser. Nasty, scary, terrifying. Reinforce all! How is he marine-wise? We got scans saying he's got 14 Marines on board. Perfect. So we're now reinforcing all for obvious reasons. He will Hellbore us, it will hit all the shields, so there's no point really in trying to just reinforce one, because, well, we're going to hit by all of them. Well, we are going to prep another scatter pack just in case, as is our habit, whenever we can be bothered to remember. Science station, please, I require additional scanning. That is going to take 3 points of power, it is going to take time, which time is money, time is also BPV, which kind of sucks, but we are right next door to a friendly planet, so that could work out fine for us. He has dumped his fighters, I see one group. Where the heck are you guys going? They took off at quite the clip. And I'm going to open up with a missile barrage, and I'm going to turn off. Now I'm fully expect... Yeah, his phasers is not super dangerous. I am pulling off. We have all the required data we need. Shut that off, I need the reinforcements. Target the hunter killers. We took all the hits and didn't manage to die. Dump a mine, tell him to back the heck off. All weapons fired. All weapons fired, okay. Excellent. Target. Oh, are we all around on this one? Was I not paying attention to that fact? This could be messy. He's gonna wild weasel. Pop! Oh, he did not have time to react! That was beautiful. I love that. That was brilliant. That's no doubt destroyed his armor, and has destroyed his frontal shield, which leaves him hugely vulnerable to the front, quite obviously. But also, perfect running over the scatterpack. I'm surprised he didn't destroy it. I was expecting him to kill the scatterpack. That's what I would have done. He's running away, or at least trying. He's just had to drop speed, so he's maybe taking more damage to his warp coils. We are turning just a little bit. Frontal arc is the reinforcement, please, because that's where I want to defend from. I'm going to have to constantly turn off from him so I can't just, you know, only cover the front. System's not yet ready to fire. It's that darned B-type point defense system that's telling me that it's ready to shoot, and it is not. Okay, that arc is gigantic. He's got, like, a disruptor level on him. We are steadily wiping out his rear shields. He has gone for the Wild Weasel. A mistake, of course. We're going to pull away. Get some distance on him. He's lost his rear type cheese. And we will continue to prod at that. How many do you have left? 9. I could have taken it, but that's not going to happen. This will finish all of him. It did not. That is impressive. Not gonna lie. That is honestly God impressive right there. In the spirit of honoring your impressiveness, sir. 5 people on board. Pull away a bit. A little bit more. Okay, we have an advantage. So, in honor of just how much damage you tanked, man, I'm going to steal you and add you to my collection, because honestly, that was pretty impressive. I think we can all agree that your engineers did a fabulous job. So, yeah, you're mine. I just hope, against hope, that I don't get penalized for doing this. Because if you capture ships during an ambush, it reduces points from you for whatever reason. Because apparently you're like the attacking ships now, and you've lost both of your ships, so it's a huge embarrassment, but in reality you should be gaining that cash? Take me the ship, come on. Thank you. It's a little bit messed up. It's obviously a bug. There's no way they could have intended for that to happen, but, it is what we've got to work with. So once again, my Marines capturing another wonderful ship. 440. Did quite well today, apparently. And into dry dock. Hello, shipyard. We're at 4870. That definitely brings us into 5,000 range. 13,200 for a B-11V, which is a carrier battleship. I think the B-11's the biggest, baddest thing out there. Ooh, the new full-on X-type ships are out. XFF, an X-type frigate. He is equipped with 2 heavy disruptors, 2 missile racks, 2 phaser Gs, and 6 phaser Xs, and he probably has shields through the roof. Not interested, though. We want heavy cruiser to dreadnought range, and I'm not seeing that. Huh, that's kind of disappointing. Supply patch the minuscule amount of damage we took. Wonderful. Excuse me. I need 12 marines. I need the additional mine that I dumped. I didn't spend any spare parts. Oh, that's pretty good. We have spent quite a few admin shuttles and full-on missiles. Again, a bit expensive, but worth it. We just... A surprise reversed. Excellent. A wonderful mission to go on for any occasion, for the whole family. Tends to pay out pretty well, and they can't defend themselves, which is the best part about it. We are going to, of course, prep scatterpack. Select all systems. There's the enemy fleet. And are we going at a full speed? We are not quite yet. Target. Frigate. 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 Light cruiser. Okay, and we are starting from the maximum spawn distance. Which means this could get ugly. Come on. I need more power. I need more power for the engines. We need to put everything forward to travel towards them. All power. We're going to basically be prepping as many scatter packs as we can along the way, and we'll dump 1, 2, 3, and then hit them as hard as we can. Hopefully they won't have too much defenses, but this, of course, being the race that has Jeep-type phasers, so the fact that we hope they don't have too much defenses, they might not, and yet they'll still have enough defenses to shoot down pretty much everything I shoot at them. If we had a friendly ship in this operation, that'd be great. Let's see. Missiles last for 3 turns, right? Right. One, I'm going to fire 2 barrages at you, then scatterpack you, then... You get the idea of what we're going to do. We're just going to seed everything we can. Scatterpacks are ready. First scatterpack will target you, buddy. Oh, I can't control too many missiles. Duh. I'm not the Marak. I don't have triple links. So we will fire everything. We will fire 2 salvos at you. We'll wait for them to hit. And then we'll dump the scatterpack and... Yeah, this mission is getting a little bit complicated. But you all get the idea. More missiles. Wonderful. Now we'll take the light cruiser the longest to warm up, I believe. I believe it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think. But we normally don't allow anybody but one guy to get up to full power. So this could be interesting. Charging up. Coming in for a run. Triple fusion cannon. You're dangerous, man. And drop speed down to combat speed. Check back on you. It's going to be a little while before the missiles get there. Unselect those because I can't use them yet. And point blank range is now not enough to kill you. All systems select. That didn't... He shot them all down. That's not great. Scatterpack. Scatterpack. And I didn't prep the next scatterpack. I'm an idiot. Okay, slow down to our cruising speed, I guess. I guess that's what we would consider cruising speed. We have no weapons available quite yet. Turn, turn, turn. It's going to be point blank. It is point blank. Perfect. And... Come on. Come on. Rear phasers. Not enough to kill. Wow, we're damaging everybody. We're killing nobody. So this is not going super well. But you are pretty heavily damaged, actually. You are decently damaged, and you are mauled. If you have an active system on board, I don't know what it is. So you're about to get the next blast of everything that we've got to give, because you're the biggest thing and scariest thing. The Baron Happus. He did manage to shoot down 3 of them. Oh, just 2. I thought he shot down all 4 of them. Well, initially I thought 4, then I saw that there was one coming out, so I was, oh, maybe we only got 2, and then, you know, that went pretty well, actually. Putting a lot of firepower into these people. Turning as hard as we possibly can. What are we not charging? Because I'm looking at this, it says 42 of 44, and we're traveling at a speed of 18, which is normally 43 of 44, which... What's not happening that normally is happening? The questions that we must ask ourselves. Important. Destroyer just came active. You just came... That was not the one that should have become active. Okay. And everything is going haywire. Maybe it's just totally random. Okay. Get everything out. So 1, 2, 3. He's dead. The destroyer has no power, no real weapons left anymore. He's a crippled husk. This guy actually could give us a bit of a problem. Yeah, he's doing a speed of 8. He's got nothing. Coming around for a barrage. And we're going to close into nice, super close range. Oh, only the missiles are selected, of course. That's you. Which makes my life a lot easier. Because now all my frontal weapons are available to deal with HHN over here. What's your name? I wasn't paying close enough attention. You're indeterminable. Really? Indeterminable? It is. And you're integrity. Okay. I don't think your hull integrity is that high right now. Yes, yes, I know that's not what he's talking about. Still, a decent enough joke. Not really, but you get the idea. I'm not the jokey guy, I'm just the talk-a-lot guy. put in some missiles. He doesn't have any defenses for this. This is the end for you, buddy. Excellent. Managed to wipe out an entire Hydran counterattack on the planet. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Please show me the money. Show me all the cash. Because they did at least get active. 300. Not as much as I was hoping. But that's going to be it for an episode right there. I gave you vengeance. Soaring through. We've managed to take the planet. It's only the husk remains of the Empire left, I'm sure. So, I've been Tyrek. If you like what you've been seeing, hit that like button and subscribe, and I will see you all in the next episode.